previously on the cinematic experience.
What, the wrong audience? It's really just sad.
Like strangers.
Yeah. Or old people, really old people.
Or really depressed, recently divorced people.
Yeah, unless they're like you.
Thanks for joining us here on the Cinematic Experience. My name is John Maxim.
And I'm Cameron Daly. We've been doing our best to see as many movies as possible that have been nominated for Academy Awards, trying to see them and review them before February 22nd. The Reader is up for Best Picture, as well as a couple other Oscars. To be honest, I'm probably going to get crap for this, but I think Bedtime Stories is more deserving of an Oscar than The Reader. The first 45 minutes, seriously, the first 45 minutes borders on bad softcore porn, while the last hour turns into a courtroom drama that made me wish I could see more of the uncomfortable sex scenes between the 40-year-old Kate Winslet and the 15-year-old German kid who likes to read as part of his unstimulating foreplay. Maybe the rave reviews stem from the reviewer's desire to appear intelligent or sophisticated. Or maybe they just didn't want to look stupid by ripping on a movie so many people loved. I was able to dig deep enough into the artistic cockles of my soul and give this a matinee rating. Just a matinee rating.
Oh my goodness.
What?
Dude, Academy Award movie. I don't think I could dig deep enough into the cockles of my soul.
You don't have crevices that go that deep?
No, and I make myself stupid in plenty of these reviews.
Yeah.
So if me not liking this movie is because I'm stupid, I'm happy to be stupid.
You're not going to say this movie was okay.
I give this movie a dollar theater rating. I didn't enjoy much of it at all. The first third, the bad softcore porn was bad. Like, yeah. I don't even get the point of it.
Yeah, well,
they
could have established the relationship without so much of that. Just let's find excuses to rip our clothes off.
It was just
I noticed
silly.
There's no wardrobe Academy Award nomination for this movie.
Yeah,
wardrobe.
That's seriously the first third. The courtroom drama, okay, I started to enjoy, not even then.
There were points in this movie where I thought, you know what? This is an okay movie. And it was during one of those points I looked at you and said, so, what do you think?
And I said, no, I don't like this at all.
This is horrible. Why? Yeah. What do you think? Well, I think it's all right.
No.
So, yeah, it's okay.
I didn't. And you call it an artistic movie. And I think that's why it got an Oscar. I think people are thinking there's a whole bunch of naked people in the beginning. It's about the Holocaust. We're making Kate Winslet, who's very pretty, be ugly most of the time. It's very artistic. But if you're going to go to the great lengths to make it artistically accurate and give Kate Winslet in all of her nude scenes this big old bushy armpit hair, maybe you can make sure that the main character's accent doesn't change from the time when he's a boy to the time when he's an adult.
Ralph
I'm
Fiennes.
A German speaking barely broken English to I've got
British.
A perfect British accent.
Yeah, I mean,
come on.
It did fade in and out, his accent did. And what was the point of the flashbacks anyway? Like,
there was no point.
I mean,
Why I couldn't even understand
the
that.
Only thing
it was
I
a waste of my time.
The only thing I can think of is Ralph Fiennes got the script and said, I like the script, but my role is tiny. I'm in the last 20 minutes of this movie. This 15-year-old kid gets all the cool scenes with Kate Winslet, and I'm stuck the last 20 minutes of this movie with this old fart.
Yeah.
How about you give me some flashbacks, kind of scatter me in throughout the movie, and maybe I'll
a little
do
more screen.
Yeah,
you think he demanded it
I think
in order
he demanded
to be in
screen
the film.
Time. Yeah.
Okay, that could be.
Still,
I just thought it was kind of funny that Kate Winslet brought up in the TV show Extras. Have you seen
Extras? I do watch Extras, yeah.
And at the very end, she says, if you want to get an Oscar, you got to play, you got to be in a Holocaust movie. And now she's done
so
it,
your
and here she is,
your
best actress.
She's going to get the best actress.
No, actually, I don't think she is. But I just still think it's funny that they brought it up in Extras, and here she is.
I'm still, there was enough good things, few, but there was enough for me to give it a matinee rating.
And I think there were no redeeming qualities whatsoever. Dollar Theater.
I really, really did hate that movie.
I really did.
I know, you did. You really did.
Is it because I'm stupid?
I think it is.